This story begins with a multi-million dollar failure, which might just lead to a revolutionary advance in renewable energy. A company called Davenport Newberry drilled a couple of wells, like this one, nearly 2 miles deep, just outside the Newberry Volcanic Crater in central Oregon. They had hoped desperately to find hot water.
We had very high temperatures in excess of 550 degrees Fahrenheit. We were very excited about that, but no hot water and no steam. It was heartbreaking. We had spent upwards of $30 million at that point.
For decades, geologists figured if any place in Oregon would be good for geothermal energy, it would be here at Oregon's largest volcano. Laws prohibit drilling within the actual Newberry Monument. The drillers had expected better results from these wells that lie just outside the boundary.
If you look at a heat map of the United States, the Cascades are a nice bright spot, and there's a huge area of hot rock underneath us. All these volcanoes have a lot of heat energy stored in the rock around those volcanoes.
Geologists dream of tapping into the ultimate renewable energy, the endless heat trapped in the Earth's own core. Sometimes the planet vividly displays the energy that it's hoarding. In Yellowstone, steam and hot water flaunt themselves at every turn. In Hawaii, the Earth cracks wide open, spewing red-hot lava into the sea. But the Newberry volcano doesn't show off. She keeps her heat under wraps. However, there is one way to glimpse the power underfoot. To see it, we motor across Palina Lake, hop out on the northeastern shore, and promptly dig a hole.
You don't have to dig far. Temperatures can reach up to 135 degrees right here.
This pool is so hot that I can stand in here for, that's about it, that hurts. That's too hot.
Just inches from the cool water of the lake, you can dig your own hot springs. The temperature varies.
Clean, clear, warm water. These hot springs are absolutely amazing. It makes your skin and hair feel great. It's so awesome, it's so much fun.
People who soak at Newberry Crater enjoy an unadvertised benefit of playing in this active, enormous volcano.
The sleeping giant is what the USGS refers to it as, because people don't even realize it's here. It's so large, it's hard to wrap your arms around it. I mean, we're sitting on the largest volcano in Oregon, the largest volcano in the Cascades, 20 times the size of Mount St. Helens. We're talking an area of 1,200 square miles.
Newberry's lava flows stretch for 75 miles across a landscape filled with smaller volcanic cinder cones. A 9,000-foot mountain once stood here before it collapsed 75,000 years ago to form the giant hole we see today. Since then, it has erupted another 50 or 60 times, most recently 1,200 to 1,300 years ago. That's what left behind the massive obsidian flow. It's an easy volcanic feature to spot. But the volcano's inner plumbing has been hard to figure out.
This is one of the evidence that we have of the potential power of this volcano that we're in. And of course, that's what triggered all this interest in geothermal power, the fact that we don't have to go that far down to get to these hot temperatures.
While hot water bubbles up in the middle of the caldera next to the lakes, just outside, on the volcano's flanks, drilling hasn't found a drop.
But what that left us was an excellent opportunity to test EGS.
Well number 5529 is that dry hole. The end of this wellhead lies 10,000 feet deep. The rock down there bakes at 600 degrees Fahrenheit. Will Osborne is with Alter Rock Energy. His firm partnered with the well drillers, Davenport Newberry. They are spending more than $44 million, half from taxpayers, to prove that EGS, enhanced geothermal systems, could turn this hot, dry well into a source of limitless renewable power.
The way to expand geothermal in this country is by creating our own EGS reservoirs in all that hot rock that is waiting there for us.
Since there's no hot water down below, they'll pump it down there. But there's no empty cavern waiting to be filled up. So they plan to make their own reservoirs nearly 2 miles underground by breaking the rock with high-pressure water.
We use the natural fractures in the rock. So when we inject water at high pressure, we're opening up the natural fractures in the rock and just causing those to slip a little bit. And when they slip, the irregularities in the rock will cause those cracks to remain open. We're talking about cracks that are millimeters thick in aperture, so 1 to 2, 3 millimeters, maybe that big.
They hope to create not just one, but 3 reservoirs, stacked on top of one another underground. The plan is to pump cold water down into those cracks. The earth then heats it up. They would then drill new wells off to the side to pump that now hot water back to the surface to power turbines.
The concept of EGS, though, is to create a closed cycle. You bring the hot water to the surface, extract the heat, and then put the cool water back in.
There is likely to be one side effect of forcing so many cracks into the subterranean rocks. Lots of very small earthquakes. Most under 1 magnitude, though perhaps a few up to 3.5 or 4. Will Osborne says they're not likely to cause any damage because this area is so far from nearby towns.
In this case, we're not talking about earthquakes so much as microseismic events. Generally don't get large enough to be felt.
I think there will be some very low magnitude earthquakes, highly localized around the drilling sites. And it's very unlikely that you would actually be able to feel those earthquakes, but our instruments are sensitive enough that they would actually be able to detect them.
Ben Paulk is a geophysicist with the U.S. Geological Survey. The USGS is not a partner in the geothermal experiment, but it happens to be installing 8 brand new seismic sensors around Newberry at an opportune time.
It's a pretty high threat volcano, and the last eruption in Newberry was a little over 1,200 years ago, the big obsidian flow. It's very likely that it will erupt again in the future.
With the new sensors scattered in and outside the caldera, USGS will be able to watch any volcanic activity live as it happens. It also puts them in the perfect position to pick up any tremors that may occur at the enhanced geothermal site nearby.
We will be in a better position to distinguish if the earthquakes that are occurring as a result of the injection are indeed a result of the injection, or if they're a result of magma accumulating in the magma chamber beneath the volcano.
Alta Rock had wanted to try this same geothermal experiment a few years ago in California at the geysers. It's the largest geothermal field in the world, but the company never got a chance. Electricity producers there had already been injecting water, which caused earthquakes, just large enough that people nearby complained. These days, that leads to another comparison to one of the energy industry's most controversial practices. Isn't this like fracking, where drillers fracture the rock to extract natural gas?
In hydrofracking that's done in the oil and gas industry, they actually shatter the rock. They break the rock and create new cracks, new fractures in the rock. And we just inject cold, clean groundwater. In hydrofracking, they use a mixture of chemicals.
Enhanced geothermal already produces power in Europe. At the Newberry experiment, a power plant isn't even part of the plan. Yet. If they can get hot water from a dry hole, then geothermal energy might be possible all across the country.
That's the Holy Grail. Why is it the Holy Grail? Because it's baseload power from geothermal energy. It's available 98% of the time, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, 365 days a year.
We're enhancing the productivity of the geology of the earth to produce hot water. The difficulty is making that reservoir. So that's what this demonstration is about.
Great people just doing their thing in their own Northwesty way. We love bringing you stories like this. Support what you love. OPB.org/video.